So, yeah. All right. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Happy Friday. Welcome to strength class. My name is Heather. You will need today a mat and a selection of dumbbells, heavy, moderate, and light. You'll want to use some lighter dumbbells for our part two of our warm up. And of course, any weights you need for modifications, feel free to grab those. We're going to start standing with our beginning of our warm up. We will use the mat in it. So have a mat out and nearby. How's everybody feeling this fabulous Friday? Yeah, we made it to our workout. Welcome. All right, we're going to start with good mornings or a body weight deadlift because I need your hamstrings ready today. Hands up, shoulder blades drawn together, soft bend in the knees. Beautiful. Just hinge and stand up. That's all we're going to start with today. Nice and easy movement. I want you to think about your tailbones and just stick them right up to the ceiling. You should feel stretching occurring on the back of the thighs. Once you hit that point, just stand back up. Now, just to add some flavor, I'm going to add rotation to this. You're going to hinge, rotate, elbows stay wide to the window, come back through, and then do the same thing. Hinge, look at the door. Hi, Lori. Center. And if this does not feel well, if you have back issues, maybe just do the good mornings right now. Your goal is to keep the shoulders high and shoulder blades drawn together, please. Take a bigger exhale when you rotate, like you're squeezing and rinsing out the spine, but we're really just actively warming up the core, the lower back, a little bit of shoulder action here as they're in isometrics. In 10 seconds, team, we're going to head to walkouts. You're already in position to go, so we might as well, right? In three, in two, next time you're up, I want you just to hinge. You can let the hands go. Walk your hands out to a high or a modified plank. You choose. Come back through. Stand up. Add any moves you want. You can just stay there and look at me. That's okay too. When you get into a plank or a push-up position, always open the fingertips wide and always externally rotate the hands just a smidge. It's going to give the pectorals a lot more activation than it is the delts, and that's our goal. Warming up the core. Again, the posterior side of the body. Maybe pick up the pace. It's okay if you don't today. We get 45-ish minutes together. I do have two pages of notes, so I'm going to have to cut us off probably at some point. When you're ready, hold your high plank for just a split second, please. Options. Drop to your knees if you need. Otherwise, stay in your plank. Lift your right heel to the sky. Flex your toe. Bend your knee, draw a circle, one direction. Yeah, if you need, drop your left knee down. We're just going to do a short set, one direction, each leg. Try to hold your plank or your tabletop for the whole thing. If you can, remember what I said about the hand placement. Three, two, set that foot down, lift your left heel, flexed. Bend your knee, circles, drawn. Actively warming up obliques and hips. This move a little hard, the next move not as challenging. Four, three, two, everybody drop the knees. Some of you might need to come off of the knees and stand up. I want you to kneel and lunge, alternating between the two. If you've been to athletic stretch, knee or lin, you may have done this in class. Go right side and left. If you need to come up, just do some alternating lunge. Maybe come off of your center. Take care of some hip stretching, especially those of you that just did cycle. Your hips are actually warm enough too. You remember the easy stuff, right? So when we get to the hard stuff, you won't be so mad at me. I always remind you of that. We're going to do some bridge work, single leg, and some walkouts on our backs in less than 10. Three, two, when you're ready, flip yourself up and over, lie down. Oh, we get to lay down on the job already. Sweet. We want to activate the hips and the glutes and the hamstrings. So put your feet under your knees to start. Everybody lift your butt and squeeze. Palms are down flat on the mat or just on the outside edges. I want you to extend just the right leg. Try to straighten it if you can and hold. Flex your toes back really hard here. Squeeze your left butt cheek. If you need to know that it's on, touch it. It's right there. Make sure it's on. Beautiful. Set your right foot down. Extend the left. Flex your foot. Short set here. Ideally, we would do this 2 to 3 times. We ain't got time. We got a part two coming up. So we're almost to part two. Same thing. Squeeze your right. Lift both hips to the sky. 3, 2, keep your feet down, hips up. Now lift your toes up. And I want you to walk out as far as you can without dropping your butt and walk back in. We're just going to do about 4 passes here. Try to keep the hips as high as possible and go out as far as possible without dropping your butt on the ground. Your hamstrings should be firing up right here. I don't know why, but I feel like I always have to march like a dinosaur. Roar, roar, roar. Let's do one more. Everybody find your way. Oh! When you come back in, you're going to stand up, grab a light to medium set of dumbbells. You can move your mat out of the way. We have single leg deadlift, single leg shrimp squat, double dumbbell today. If you've not done these, you might want body weight or one weight. Yeah, I know. Isn't that weird? So here's how it's going to go down. You're going to get about 20-ish seconds option. Double up, right into single leg, short shrimp squat. We're just going to do right, left, 2 times, unfortunately. If it gets to be too much, because this is still warm up, I don't want you cashing out. Drop down to 1 dumbbell. Everybody kickstand your left toe, soft bend in the right knee. Here we go. Double up, short range of motion here. This isn't all the way down to the ground. I don't need that. I just want your hamstrings to liven up. Your hips and your glutes. You'll notice even just by adding 2 little dumbbells, this makes a big difference. Flat back, that means shoulder blades together. Stand up, hold it. Now you can keep your toe here. Start to bend your front knee, the knee points forward. If it feels okay, try to lift your toe and continue. Brilliant. This isn't the heavy load. This is just the activation, the stability and balance. 3, 2, left foot down, right toe kickstand, deadlift. Nice, Carrie. We were dancing next door at 11:15. We danced on the bike today. I know, it's Friday, why not? Stop bending that standing leg. 4, 3, 2, you start here, knee forward. It's just a bend in the knee now, it's not a hinge. Option, lift your foot, slow it down if you need. The balance is hard here. Yeah. 3, 2, take a little tiny break. You're gonna repeat that 1 more time. Then we're gonna get the heavy stuff out. Going to be a lot of choreography for the brain, and then we're going to be on an AMRAP right away. It's going to be a big duration of work. All right, same thing, 5 seconds. Single leg deadlift. 3, 2, let's go. It's just 20 seconds. I don't need a lot. I need range of motion. This is warm up. If you knew you were going to go pick up a barbell right now that was 400 pounds, this would prep you for it. You would be warm enough and prepared. We have that single leg squat in 3, 2, here it is. With or without the weight, with or without the toe down. Yuck. These never get easier, and then every week we keep adding load. We switch in 3, 2, left foot down, deadlifts. I'm going to try to remember. I have a bunch of alternative options on my notes today because sometimes I forget when you need options. So I'll do my best to give those today in case you need mods. 3, 2, single leg. Here it is. Last 20 seconds. We have a complex coming up next. That's where we're going to get heavy load and we're going to lighten or lessen the reps. Last 3, 2, 1. I jumped past the complex already. The other set. All right. Still one kind of heavy. You're going to do this 3 times. You have a minute to accomplish 5 reps of each move. And if we go over a minute, we don't care. I'm just trying to keep us on task. 3 times, here's what it's gonna look like. Option 1, same thing you just did, heavier load. 2 dumbbells, you're gonna either kickstand 5 reps, watch my options, 5 reps, or 5 reps. If you have back problems, this is actually a great strength move, but don't do it if you have back pain. So rotated deadlift, 5, listen up, 5 suitcase, 5 push-ups, recover, repeat that 3 times. So light on the reps, heavy on the load if you can. If you've never done a rotated deadlift, try it. If it doesn't feel right, just get out of it. I'll start the clock here. I know, Charlie, they don't get as excited as you do. They do when it's all over and they're like, I don't either. Me too. Okay, so you could hold 1 dumbbell. You could keep your toe down. You can do just standard, some of you like to extend. This takes a little longer. Clock is starting in less than 10. 5, 5, right and left. 5 suitcase, 5 push-up. Ready? 3, 2, let's go. Nice and slow. You're not in a rush for these. Keep a soft bend in the front knee. We're incorporating lateral hip if you're using the rotation. Sides when you get your 5. Whichever 5 you choose. Then you do 5 deadlifts or 5 suitcase deadlifts. I like this case for the upper body appeal. You should get quite a bit of recovery because I lessened our movements and our reps. 45 to 60 seconds of work is what we're doing. And you can do push-ups on your palms, your knees, your toes, etc. Just 5 of them. When you finish, take your accounted break. You're going to do it 2 more times, so get heavier load. Take your rest. Your complex should allow your heart rate to come up a little bit. Shouldn't feel wrecked. This is your strength component. We're going to do it again. Same exact thing 2 more times. You got 10 seconds, a little over. Did your heart rate come up a little bit for that? It's all the posterior chain. All right, get ready. Pick up your weights. 3, 2, here we go. Step 2. Same rep scheme. Slow, heavy. That's what I'm looking for. Good news for those of you that like to work fast. You have some of that today. You're going to be on an AMRAP several times today, single arm. You might hate me at the end of class. I don't care. Oh, okay. Or now. Slow and steady wins the race here. Really strong push-ups. Get big range of motion. If you want to skip the push-ups, you have my permission. We don't have a lot of focus on push-ups today. After our next one, our strength here, we go strength condition. Right side, left side, hopefully 2 times, right, left, right, left. If she doesn't beat me. She's going to try that clock, you know. All right, how are we holding up so far? Yeah, body's getting ready. Good, because you're going to want to be ready for what's next. You got 6 seconds. Last set, best set for this round. 3, 2, here we go. Remember, don't rush. Everything is by controlled movement, not strength training. Nice rotations, you guys. They must be feeling pretty good. You wouldn't want to do these all the time. And I wouldn't recommend you do them in high rep volume kind of a thing.
But we often train just in the sagittal plane and we need to learn to get out of that. And everything I have listed for you pretty much is sagittal plane. So I thought, you know, let's mix it up a little bit. Draw the elbows close to the body, not far away. Keepers, we got a river up here. Hydrate. You got a little recovery. I'll get us ready. Here's where we're going. You're going to do a really simple complex with me. Once we do this complex, you're going to catch your breath, and then I'm putting us on a 3-minute clock, and it's a new complex. So there's a lot of moves to learn, but once you learn them, you'll be fine. You have a split stance, split jerk, which I know how much y'all love the split jerks. So it's a 3, 4, 5 for your heavy load. We're going to start here. I've got options for you. So you'll do 3 split jerks. 3 times here, then you're going to hit 4 push press. From here, you're going to rack 5 reverse lunges. Soon as you're done with that, 3-minute AMRAP starts. You have, good God, Heather, 5 push, everything's 5 here. 5 push press, 5 thrusters, 5 snatches, 5 lunges. All right. Then we'll do the same thing on the left. I'd go moderate weight for your first round. You're going to get right and left twice. So if you do 20 pounds on the right, do 20 on the left. In set 2, you could try for heavier. If you're like, I don't want to find out the hard way, just go heavy and see what you got. I know you're going to have a lot of questions. I'm going to come with you. So it is 3, 4, 5 heavy. That's where we start. You do that once. We pause, then it's a 3-minute AMRAP, 5, 5, 5, 5. I'm going to walk you through it though. So we do 3 split jerks, 4 push press, 5 lunge to prep. Just on the right side. I want you to go as heavy as you can here. Split jerk, for those of you new, I should assume, not assume things. You can just lunge this. Our right arm stays left leg. Separate your feet. You step in, forward, done. Here, left, right, recover 3 times. Cool, let's give it a try. Then you 4 push press, 5 lunge. With me, little dip in the hips, let's go. 3, front, back, recover. 2, nice, slow it down, we're not in a hurry. Beautiful Friday. Now push press for 4. Dip jerk, or just overhead. Front rack, lunge, 5 of them. Beautiful lunges. Recover. Breathe. In 10 seconds, I'm starting a clock. It's 3 minutes. It's going to get ugly. 5 push press, 5 thrusters, 5 snatch, 5 lunge. Get ready. 3, 2, go. 5 push press. Just on the right. 5 thrusters. That means you squat to press. You're going to have to take breaks here. Please do. 5 snatches. That is a pull and punch. 5 of them. Not a squat snatch. Nice. You would do that. 5 lunges. You can front rack or farmer if your upper body needs rest. Yeah. All 5s back to the push press. Now listen, you have 2 minutes and 10 seconds to do that again and again and again. So take your recovery, get back in. Thruster, nice. Snatches. Holy crap. If you went heavy enough, these are going to get tough. Halfway. Flat back on the snatch, it's a squat. You lunge. Oh, 75 seconds to go. Now everybody's gonna want like a million hours of recovery between these. We don't get a million, we get a little. Then we repeat it all on the left. Less than a minute. See if you can get one more round. Wow. You're getting strength and conditioning. What does that mean, Heather? It means your heart rate's coming up. Yeah, you're getting a little cardiovascular along with power out of the hips, power out of the shoulders. I know. 22 on the clock. Come on now, finish what you can finish. 10 seconds. Three, two, recover. Heart rate come up. Me too. Grab water. Now we're going to do the same thing, the complex. Same exact thing. Slow and controlled, heavy. Brief break. 3 minutes. All on your probably, well, my weaker side. Huge percentage of us have a weaker side on the left. We're not worried about weakness though. That is our job right here, right now, is to find our weakness and pray on it. Did I find ours? Yeah. You're like, I didn't come for conditioning. Well, it's Friday. Doesn't matter. Cool. All right, less than 20. Split jerk on the other side. So if you want to practice it right now, do it without the weight. Slow. Speed. Recover, recover. Three of those. Four push press, five lunge, one time through. Get ready. It's right. Left arm, right leg, split jerks. I'm gonna start the clock back over for this part and then the 3 minutes. Get ready. Set, here we go. Recover it, front, back, set. Two, front, back, set. Three, now you push press, four of them. Lunge, five of them. All right, listen up. Left side goes. Push press, thruster, snatch, lunge. I can already feel the sides like, nah, I'm gonna be taking lots of breaks on this one. 5 seconds. Get ready for your push press. Three, two, let's go. 3 minutes. So you know you don't want to race, right? Because you know the 3 minutes is a long ride. If you go out of the gate too hot, it's not comfortable. Weights in the heels and those squats. Are you feeling stronger? I don't know if strong is the right word, Heather. It is. Yeah. You take recovery when you need. Oh, good news. 1 minute in, 2 minutes to go. Try to match right and left with the amount of rounds. You could skip the overhead here and just do the squat. You could do a bent over row instead of a snatch. I like all the mods I see. I know it's not easy, y'all. We didn't sign up for easy today. We signed up for something that's gonna make us move. Something that might change my mind or my body. Put yourself in the mood. Just get there, you're doing great. Yeah. 1 minute left. Maritza's favorite, AMRAPs. Do you find a weakness? Mine is always my left side. Try to get through another round. You got 45 seconds. We take a full recovery, a bigger recovery. Use your power now. I'm curving. 15 seconds. I'm trailing a little behind my side one. Three, two, time. I know none of you remember this, but I'm going to tell you this. You have to do that all one more time. You didn't hear me when I said right, left, right, left. That was right, that was left. You had to do it one more each side. Look at their faces. No! So we're gonna repeat it. So now you know how to work hard. Everyone's like, let me use the bathroom, let me disappear. You're on a big recovery. You got about another minute. We go back into the right. If you need to lighten the load, lighten the load. Certainly, especially in that AMRAP. And then we'll see how much time we have. I think I'm going to have a little circuit to finish. It'll be a little typical strength circuit, and then we'll be done. So that's really all we're going to have time for. So you better make it effective. I got about 35 seconds of your time for recovery. Hydrate. You start with a split jerk, right side, left leg is going to split forward. Nice, good practice. Anytime you don't know or don't feel comfortable in the split jerk or a jerk, you should practice it with no weight. Do you think you could pick up the same weight? I don't know, give it a try. I'm going to go with you. You remember, it's right arm, left leg forward. All right, inhale. Open mouth, exhale. Pick up your dumbbell, right arm. Three times. Three, two, let's go. Split jerk. Make sure you recover properly. You want to stick that landing for sure. Push press to overhead four times. Lunge. I don't care what kind of lunge you choose. Right leg stays forward. Five times. It's just 3 minutes and it's the last time on the side. How bad can it be? I will tell you this much. There's a reason I like repeating things. This will feel different. Good or bad is up to you, but it'll feel different. Five push press, you remember it? Five thruster. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, clock begins right now. On the right, 5555. Like a phone number, but better. No rushing, not unless you are feeling fly. That's up to you. Maybe determine how many rounds you can get through and see if you can match it. Right and left. You take a break somewhere in here, nobody cares. It's totally on you. We reverse lunge to catch our breath. You got cardio and strength built in here. 50 seconds in. Yeah. I'm with you. It feels a little uncomfortable. It's okay. Be uncomfortable. It's how you change your body. It's my biggest belief. You hear people say, you don't have to be so hard on yourself. I think you do. You know why? Because we get lazy and complacent. We're not doing that here. Not on my clock. You can do it at 1 o'clock. When we stretch today, you can be lazy. I don't even mind. But not right now. So much happening in the body. Hips, core, upper body, heart, lungs. We're leaving nothing to rest, which is why this feels like almost impossible. But it's not impossible. I wouldn't give it to you if it was. Oh, my favorite. 1 minute. That rack position is getting hard to hold. Does it matter how many rounds you get? Nope. Between you and you. Here's the good news. It's up to you. Here's the bad news. It's up to you. You might bow out on yourself here. I don't want you to. You got 22 seconds on the clock. Finish what you can finish. You're going to break. Anyone else want me moving slower this round? 5, 3, 2, 1. I lost almost a whole round. Don't even care. How you hold up? How your traps feeling? Like, that's your traps, those big things coming in your ears. We have shoe goals in my class. Does anybody know what they are? Traps and quads. That's all I care about. That's not a true statement, but it is kind of true. They're important muscle groups. All right, we got 25 seconds. Get a little nervous, get a little excited. All the emotion you feel should drive you, not scare you. It should drive you. Like, rah! Left side's gonna go. Practice now. We got less than 10. Everybody get ready. 3, 2, 1. Recover it. You look great today. 3, 4 push press. Little dip in the hips. Yeah. 5 lunge. Wherever you want to hold the weight. Weights in the front heel. Hey. This is absolutely one of those sets where I'm like, just rip the band-aid off. Just rip the band-aid off. It's 3 minutes. You scale it however you need. You get to write this story. All you have a little circuit after that, then we recover. We're almost done with class. You might as well cram it in, right? 10, 5, 5, 5, 5. Push press, thruster, snatch, and lunge. Last time. 3, 2, here we go. Everything you need that sucks. Nice recovery, John. Oh, we found love. Great tune. Remixed with my favorite song. What are we gonna do? What? Yes, Maritza. She's having a party back there. Are you having a party? You're like, I don't know if this is a party, huh? I'm not sure. Did y'all miss me last week? Yeah, me too. I could tell though I had a week off. I can feel a week off. You're approaching it. 1 minute left. I know. It feels like the whole ceiling just came down. I know. Watch your form now that you're tired. My strategy, get my 5 in rest. The only way I'm getting through it. 30 seconds. Get on the point. You give yourself a pat on the back with your very tired arm. Grab water. Recover. I want your mat, your heavy weight, a set of weights that you can stand on. We're going to do a heel elevated squat. We're going to start with a bench press. So a mat, heavy weight, bench, stand up for a heel elevated squat, and then do triceps overhead. I know you can modify if you want to do something different like biceps. Or core. I was going to make you do a squat finisher, but we got way too many squats in already. So we'll just keep a few. So when you come up for squats today, option for a goblet, body weight, or heavy suitcase. We're going to heel elevate these bad boys and work on our knee strength. If you're like, no, I'm not, your feet will be on the floor. Well, heavy load for all of them in 30 seconds apiece. I want 3 sets in time for this. We do a bench press, a squat, and then a tricep overhead if you need to do kickbacks or a plank or curls. You've almost had enough recovery. We're going to start the clock in about 20 seconds. How's your central nervous system feeling? Same. Hydrating is going to be key, especially because you're going to get up early tomorrow and come cycle with me at 8:15. Yeah, you are. 10 seconds. Pick them up safely. Lie down carefully. I want you to bring your elbows out on the floor, just below the shoulders. Palms are going to face your knees when you're ready. We bench press. Heavy as you can get me for 30 seconds. This will go very quickly after a 3-minute AMRAP. You might feel fatigued and a little shaky. That's not abnormal. We're going back to strength now. No more conditioning piece here. You've gotten a lot of things done for the body today. You have my permission to be lazy the rest of today. 3, 2, and 1. Keep 1 heavy dumbbell or 2 heavy. You either goblet hold it or you suitcase hold. I'll give you 6 seconds. Heels up, toes forward, knees forward. Stand up, let's go. Slow, really slow. Keep your hips towards your heels. Chin is parallel to the floor. Nice work. If this does not feel okay on your knees, get your heels down or drop the weight. And the seconds left, nice work. We're gonna build some seriously bionic knees here. 4, 3, 2, 1. Triceps, one heavy, two light, or kickbacks very light. Pick it up. From here, let's go. I'm just as tired as y'all. I think I'm gonna only make us do 2 sets, okay? Just 2. Keep us on task. We've really done a lot today. Halfway. Your shoulders are just tired, that's all. You won't need them for cycle tomorrow, though. See what I did there? Keep the rib cage pulled in, pull it in. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's just do that one more time and then we're gonna recover. Then you're all done. One more and we're done. That's it. I know you were hoping that would be the case. Lesson, get in position when you're ready. Clock begins in 5, 4, 3, 2, let's go. Bench press your hands, get kept in your last 30 here. Keep the core nice and tight, feet are down on the ground. You press the heavy weight directly up into gravity. 8, 6, 4, 3, 2, come on out. We move back in for our final heel elevated set of squats. They feel amazing today, don't they? Or at this point in class, I should say. Get yourself set up quickly. I'm watching the clock, 5 seconds. If you want a bonus set, start right now. Clock begins right here. It's never gonna hurt you to do an extra 5, 10, or 15 seconds of movement. You can feel your quads blowing up here for sure. These are nicknamed cyclist squats. They're for cyclists. That's us, Spar at 8:15. Oh, no. Go, Hunter, go! 3, 2, 1. Oh, my gosh. Oh, triceps, one more time. Any variation you want. 6 seconds to get there. 3, 2, let's finish this. Nice options, team. It's all about alignment now. Shoulders are down. Arms straighten the face. Try to get the weight way down. Overhead plank. My heart is just racing and a tricep overhead. 5, 4, 3, 2, time. Amazing work. For those of you that can stay, we're going to cool down and stretch. Yeah.